There will be moments where you will be broken. When you exercise leadership, there will be times that event, resistance, sabotage, enemies, you name it, failure, might and will break you. It will happen. Even if you don't exercise leadership, the nature of life that is by default about suffering, about tragedies, about pain, about losing people, about sickness, about disasters, man-made or human-made or nature-made. These things will happen, and they're the default of nature, and these things will break you. At least they will try to break you. Maybe not intentionally, but by the nature of their heaviness, they will break you. What do you do in these situations? You have one purpose. In this situation, you have one purpose, and that is to survive and to heal. Because with a broken nature, with a broken spirit, with a broken soul, you can't continue. Just like with a broken leg, you can't walk, let alone run. With a broken soul, with a broken spirit, with a broken morale, with a broken heart, you can't continue. So in this situation, healing must become your first priority. You leave everything else and you focus on healing. And the sooner you heal, the faster you'll come back on track. So how do you heal? There are many ways of healing. Most importantly, find your own ways of healing. Your body and soul will tell you how to heal. If you need a break, take a break. If you need to cry, cry. If you need to reach out to friends, reach out to friends. If you need to seek expert help, seek expert help. If you need to pray, pray. If you need to scream, scream. If do whatever your soul from inside is asking you to do. If you need to be by yourself, be by yourself. So your soul will tell you what to do. Do that. Another thing you can do is, as I said, is get experts' help, because sometimes you will be so broken that you will need help to pick yourself again. Just like some wounds you can fix by yourself, you know, put a hand, you know, band-aid, and it's fine. Some other wounds you need to get professional help so that they can stitch you. So never ignore getting the necessary help. Do that. Now I will come to my third and key point of my message. One of the best ways of healing, my friends, is to help other people who are equally broken like yourself. There is a magical energy of healing when you help others. Because when you're helping other people who are broken like you, when you help them heal, you're indirectly healing your soul. And there is a third magic to this. People who are watching you, helping others who are broken heal, they will also be healed. I don't know why this happens. I don't know the miracle behind this dynamic, but it's a reality. Just like when you feel people helping each other, you feel energized, you feel hopeful, you feel happy, you regain your hope about life in general. You get encouraged when you see strangers helping each other. Other people will feel the same when they see you helping broken people heal. Especially when they see you as a broken person helping another broken person heal. Imagine you're wounded and you're limping, and with despite of your wound, you're helping another wounded person walk. You're asking another wounded person who's also limping to lean on you in spite of your wound. Imagine the beauty and the energy that comes from that. So the best way when you feel that you're broken is to find other broken people, and I guarantee you there are plenty. Especially if other people like you who are experiencing the same kind of devastation or trauma or stress or disappointment or pain or suffering or tragedy or loss that you're going through. And in many cases, you won't be alone. There will be other people within your family, your friends, your society, your neighborhood, your country, your community. So it's not difficult to find such broken people. Just look around you. And the first person you can help, the first person who's asking for help, the first person who needs help, is available for help, just reach out to them and help them. And miracles will happen. They will heal, you will heal, and people around you will also heal. And that's leadership.